Would you rather be Inspector General of Police or Buhari? Would you rather tell the future? No, it's telling the future or read somebody's mind.
If somebody wants to kill you, yeah, and the person will really win now, ego knows that the person won't kill you.
When will you Don Jazzy or lose your girlfriend? Or when will you beat your girlfriend and lose a lucrative deal with Don Jazzy?
It's Don Jazzy again. Just man, ask me, Don Jazzy.
What up, people? Welcome today on Hook and Game. I still remember myself, Frank Stan. As you all know how we do it here, your number one celebrity arena. As you can remember, the last episode was mad, and this episode today is going to be mad. You got it? I won't believe who I have in the show today. It's no other person but Rabbi. Rabbi, bro, how do you feel being on the show today?
Yeah, bro, I feel good, man. I feel great, man. It's an honor to be here, man.
Whoa. You're welcome, actually.
Yeah, thanks.
So, talking about your name, Rabbi, I was actually trying to get it straight, and I've not gotten anything straight.
No, the name, most directors and most people I work with always ask Rabbi, because it's not familiar with.
Yeah, it's not familiar with Nigerian names.
But then, when I was answering, that was the name I was answering, Lewis Baski. Yeah. I was very popular in my school there with the name.
Because
I started singing right from when I was a
senior. Oh, it's been a long time.
Yeah. So when I wanted to have my first video, so the name got us confused because of the Lewis. Because of the Lewis and the Whiskey. So my director was like, this name.
Yeah.
Whiskey has taken everything, so we have to just change it. So, but happy we came up with Rabbi, because man, the name, that, even me, I don't believe
it. I swear it suits that.
Yeah, it's sweet, I swear, yeah.
Actually, from what you say, it means like you've been long on the system. Yeah. How long have you been on the system?
I've been singing when I was a child. Everyone knows I was really into music. Yeah. I remember when I was in JS2, I woke my dad around 2. I was like, yeah, I bought my music book. I told my dad that I need money, you come and start
stuff.
I have to start showing my music. And he was like, you're still young to go into the game. I said, man, you have to start. I've been singing when I was a child, but professionally, I started singing. I had my first video when I was in SS2.
Music video?
Yeah, my first music video when I was in SS2. Then I was in Under African China. So I would say professional, I started when I was, that was 2014 or 2013.
That's about a lot of years now, back now. It's been a long time. So how many tracks did you kind of boost up since then to me?
I just dropped my EP like 2 months ago.
Oh.
And before dropping my EP, I shot a lot of videos.
Wow.
I shot the video in January. I shot the video in Abuja. And I have videos coming up.
Wow.
I have a video with Prince White.
That's right.
Yeah, I'm about to drop it, but I'm still waiting. I'm still pushing the EP. Oh. And it's making wave out there. People like it. The response are good.
Wow.
So, you know, when music most times, it's not just all about the money.
It's not right.
Yeah, you have to do what people like. You have to do something that is good. You have to create a good content.
Definitely.
It must be good. It must be meaningful. Because once the beat is good, if people get used to the beat, they want to listen to the lyrics.
Yeah.
So if a person don't dance your song, and he's tired of dancing, the person will sit and say, let me even listen to what this person is singing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So when they listen to it and feel like,
singing
rubbish, they will just get tired of the whole song at that point. So the beats and the lyrics have to come on, have to be 100%.
Before you can vibe to it.
But I thank God, we're doing great, man.
You're doing it. You just sing or do you rap as well?
No, just sing.
You sing?
Yeah.
Okay, I heard you saying about working with China. Like, how was the experience? Because China was
It was, I told you, I woke my dad up, something like that. So there was this his friend that was a kind of a group chat with my dad. He listened to my son, was like, your son has a man, so I have him to come to Lagos. That was how I went to Lagos. I went to meet him at his office. He said, in the next 2 hours, I want to go and meet African China, come with me.
Yeah.
We went to the studio, and African China had my son, and that was
it. I loved it. Yeah, he just has some feature.
Yeah, and I remember what they gave him was AC, because after recording, he told the guy that, you have to pay me, you know how much I take for future. I won't talk to your guy, something like that.
Yeah.
He said, but you like the song, Nana, you offer to join.
Yeah.
He said, I want you to do for me, man. This man is now, you know the chill again, you go change up for me.
That kind of thing.
So that was it, man. But he loved the song. We had the video like a week later.
Yeah.
And him personally, he loved the song, man. He used to tell me this song is great. Well, thank God.
Apart from him, which other big person have you worked with?
With Rough Coin,
that was
Junior.
Wow,
It was also planned. I did a good song at the studio. Then the producer was the producer that produced Ariwa. So he heard the song, he was like, Rabbi, this song is good. I'll offer a win over next week. Just chill. I don't know how much he's going to charge, but I'll send the song to him if he likes it. These songs now, these two people are major. Just it's after recording that we'll pay it. So he just like.
You find lucky.
Yeah, man. We just have to go pick him at G Towers at the suit. We went straight to the studio. After voicing, said half a day, we're going to call that. He's an about boy with this. So we just gave him, I think, 100 and something K there.
Yeah.
We just gave him, was okay, then the song is good. He just encouraged him. Yeah. Moved on, and as of last year, I also wrote a little song with Tenny, but it didn't work out because of the label. You should know she's still under Dr. Dollar, and she listened to the song. She liked the song, same thing. She wanted to jump on this one, but the condition
was much.
They gave us, they called us, and we had a meeting at last week at Yabatek. So the friend was telling us that this song is good, and Tenny is willing to jump on this one, but. If she jump on this song now, the record label boss, which is Dr. Dollar, will come for you if this song happens to be a hit. And he might arrest you or he might ask you to give him a percentage. So I have to, we both have to think. At the time, they asked us to pay a price, but the money wasn't there. But she was willing to jump on the song, but it's just the whole record label issue.
Hopefully it's going to work out.
Yeah, it's going to work out soon. I know I have plans for featuring her.
Yeah.
She's crazy, man. She's crazy. I think she's one of the best female artists now in the country.
Actually, I love her voice. Her voice is just dope. We're talking about your EP. You said you released an EP, December, right?
Yeah, December 5th, I dropped an EP. Sound and Grace.
Wow. What actually motivated you into making that EP?
You know, a lot of things motivate a talent actor or talented artist. It was during the COVID, man. You know, a lot of EPs that came out 2020 was just because of the lockdown.
Yeah.
People were just stuck in the house, and man, you just have to create music, because if you be artist, when you're there, the music you could do now. So I was just creating music. There was a lot of songs, man. Putting it one to me, it won't make sense. So I decided to, man, let me come up with an EP. And my fans already have been like, man, guy, what's up? Yeah. Drop an EP.
Do something.
Do something. Because I don't just drop songs,
Yeah.
It's like I give a dab, I drop songs and I chill. That's when I do my shit. So I have to leave Enugu. Because my producer, Wise, the producer, Techno Woman.
Yeah,
I think he's on Techno album, you said himself. So I have to move down to Owerri. So Wise also, I need to work. He said, okay, move down to Owerri, stay there a couple of days, producing music. Then after that, shout out to Wise on, man.
Yeah,
and so Wise on that king, I would like to.
Actually.
It's not easy. That's why to date, I think. Give a shout out to Sinclair. It's not easy to produce a project. Sinclair produced Whiskey album, everything.
You know who's in now?
Superstar. Now Sinclair produced everything. Forget the first thing, we don't forget that. Because you know, most times the respect that we're supposed to go to somebody, they know they give up. But everybody there. So shout out to Wisdom, man.
Wisdom
produced the whole EP and it was fucking good. But when I went to Lagos, my manager was like, how far? And you need to add more songs to this. These songs are great. You need to add more songs.
It's an EP.
Yeah, it's an EP. So I worked with this guy, Mobo. Mobo is a member of the Blue Music Store. HKM Club, we used to produce for there's this Yonda. He produced for Yonda, I think. So we have to work him up at Lakey. So we produce two extra more tracks.
On top of it.
Yeah. But the EP is a great experience.
So which one?
It took me like 3-4 months working on that project.
3 months?
3-4 months. Yeah. To be shout out to Prince White, who have to move to his house to record him.
Yeah.
Like that was during the lockdown, so although the movement was
restricted,
but it was mostly to because people were scared of the whole stuff. So we have to move down to his house. He attended us and we recorded him, and it was all from different locations. Most of the videos were studio videos. Yeah, so we have to
So in the album, actually, which one would you say actually this is the best?
Man, all of them are the best, but I think people like the father pull out there first. I have to use the father because is you would say these days people don't know the way they take people.
Sure.
People they believe say anyhow, as in, I don't know how to put it, but I believe that no matter the same way it commits, your blessing is there for you. Understand? So that's why the song was just talking about, man, nobody fit up my story, just me and my God.
Definitely.
Understand? Because I've seen where guys we do bad things, travel, come back, boutique, and start, they are still fucking good. So I can't understand still more.
NIB,
nice. So that was, and the storyline was fucking good. I sent it to a guy that was working with Frankhead World. He said, guy, the only reason I like this song is because of the storyline. It is not the regular gospel song we hear every day. This is a street, and I call it street gospel song. Right. And people like the song. Man, people, the comments. Like,
I actually went to your page and I saw the stuff.
The song is good.
So this year, what's the big thing that we're expecting from you?
I have a song I'm about to record, and I have one recorded, but I think I have couples of videos I've not dropped because I shot a lot of videos last year because it was the ending of the year, so I just have to drop further January. But I still have videos. I have one with Chris White where I've not dropped yet. I still have some live session videos, and I still have some videos I've not dropped. So I think I'm gonna drop my videos all first. So I have videos dropping this thing just for
another. So work.
Yeah,
work.
Just video
back to back
videos. But for my management, I think I'll be having a single next month, April or the upper month.
Yeah.
Understand? But before then, I think I'm dropping a video soon.
Actually, I must say I love your sound. Actually, it's a good sound. So we'll be expecting you back on this stage at any time. Seriously. Okay, at this point now, we're going to be heading to the game time. Guys, I hope you're ready for this game show. Are you ready? Yes, I'm always ready. Are you ready, man?
Man, fucking ready, bro.
Okay, the game is going to be about, would you rather be, that's the name of the game. Would you rather be this or this? I think it's going to be a tough task, so choosing from these two things. But you just have to give us some reason why you actually go for one.
Must I really go for one?
You just have to do one. You have no choice. Okay, let's go on. First, would you rather here is that? Would you rather be Inspector General of Police or Buhari? So I'll be.
I can't take any, man.
You have no choice.
If I take Buhari, the youth will kill me for
that. Last night,
if I
last.
Take it, he says, I'm keep on taking it. You can't look for any, but man, that fucking
is that bad it is? Is that bad it is? Something has to be.
You don't have to take almost a day, just like waiting for the coming of Jesus Christ to get that answer. You have to take time, man. Is it the new one or the one with the
old? Whichever one, let's say the previous one. Because you have been actually in 2000 in the start of this one.
I choose Buhari.
Why?
Because the general of police is not going to give you Buhari.
That's the last thing they give. You might not tell you, but you wait to the next one. No, Allah. Okay, let's go to the third, second one. Would you rather be gifted? Would you rather have in a dirty canal or go to jail? You know what is dirty canal? Dirty place, going there, like sleeping in the gutter. Like, have you been to Anisha? You know how dirty most of the gutters can be. Would you rather be there or go to jail?
I'd rather be there because the jail here in Nigeria will be jail.
Man.
I'd rather be there.
Okay. Would you rather tell the future? No, studying the future or read somebody's mind, like whether you see them, like seeing you now, you can read my mind.
Read someone's mind. Future.
Don't you think future is the best? Knowing what will actually happen in the future than knowing what's happening.
Okay, knowing what you're thinking is the same thing like knowing the future. Yeah. Okay, let me say, if somebody wants to kill you,
definitely.
And the person where they read mind, you go know say the person won't kill you, but you where they know future,
yeah.
Maybe now You never see the future.
I don't see future. David, I don't see everything. Before you come say run the meeting. Before you run the meeting, I run the meeting finish. Because when I want to see you, I'm going to say,
I do. It's almost the because the time you're seeing the future is the same time I'm going to read your mind.
Reading your mind is like, you see the future, I can be here. What will happen in the next, let's say, 1 month, I'm seeing it actually.
But I don't need to be where you are to read your mind, too. I don't need to be the same location where you are to read your mind. I can also be here and read your mind.
So
you
actually don't want to succumb to my own
opinion. I can't.
I'm saying that not yet. So guys, I said, what do you think we'd rather think about this? Would you see the future or read someone's mind on this situation? For me, I'm going for future things.
Yeah, bro, you have to stick your mind.
Okay, let's just this. Last one. Would you rather prefer 1 week with Don Jazzy or losing your girlfriend?
You're not supposed to ask that.
Yes.
Okay.
Let me finish. The last one is 1 week with Don Jazzy or lose your girlfriend, or 1 week with your girlfriend and lose a lucrative deal with Don Jazzy.
No artist will even, that situation shouldn't even be on the list for an artist. Like, man, who the fuck is girlfriend, bro?
What? Are you telling me that? Like,
you just ask me, Don Jazzy. Do you know I was a kid? I was a child and I knew who Don Jazzy was. Mm-hmm. I don't grow. I see the head of Jazzy. Don Jazzy is like a living legend. He stops everybody don't know anything when he concerns Don Jazzy is a hit.
Nah,
he's Don Jazzy again. And he's telling me again for
a
I guess I will carry go concert now for celebrity that will go
passion.
I don't know the option.
So you don't know the option. So girls on side. Girls, you don't follow up on this one. My dear, you don't be lucrative deal. Money matter. So guys, I think that we're at the end or edge of this show. The game time is over, and I feel so happy having you on the show today.
It was nice,
So guys,
go watch out for Frank's Dance TV, and it's coming with a lot of interviews here, and it's gonna be great.
And don't forget, don't forget to follow up us on Instagram, Frank's Dance Official, and you also.
Rabbi Official, Instagram, man.
Alright, it's gonna be on the screen. Just follow up and stick to this video. We drop it weekly basis. Thank you, guys. Peace out.